Okay, so
all
both
right,
players are
randomized
ready. This is going to be a long list of maps you're going to see appear, by the way.
It's going to be 11
and...
as opposed to the usual 7.
Yeah.
It's just so information.
Here we go.
I've been favored by Talon. He said, Levi got cookie WR by 07 and then said, never mind.
It was plus 07.
Oh, I see Diverge. I saw Diverge. Please.
Also, I saw Pox there. I was starting to forget that was in here.
Yeah.
We have not seen that in a
while. Pox hasn't been in this side of the day.
It,
it's not been day 2.
Once, right?
Yeah,
I
it was
that
day
once
yesterday.
Sorry.
But I can tell you now, Levi is good at Pox.
So Emil is gonna ban first. We're going instantly in with the Torque 2 ban. Levi coming in now, he is going to ban Nemesis and pick Quickie. So we're going to be seeing that again.
He's just practiced it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's not being played, correct?
Yep.
I think he's going to want to try and WR it.
Yeah.
I would not be surprised.
He's picked Andromeda. I think that is Emil's strongest map.
Yeah.
He has a
which, as Merky pointed out earlier, I think Levi wasn't 100% a fan of that map.
Yeah. And he doesn't turn bind the curve, so.
That changes a lot of things, though.
I mean, it changes the entire map. I'm not even joking.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't realize it was that over.
Yeah.
You save your entire
like 5 more units just from curving that ramp is turnbinding that ramp is huge.
We don't see Diverge. Tragic.
So
he's picked Messer. That's 2 people gonna be going for the Messer skip again.
Mm-hmm.
But we saw how nervous Emil was on Messer. Yeah.
Yeah, not exactly comfortable doing the run after the skip.
So all that's left is Pox, Forbidden Ways, Tronic, and Dover.
Pick Dover.
Emil.
A Levi WR.
Dover.
Forbidden Ways is out. That's kind of a good thing.
I mean, it's difficult. He has to look at those
and
4 maps. And
Levi
think.
Bans Pox. So that means Decider
Tronic.
Tronic? Tronic's the Decider.
Interesting
if it gets to it.
Decider.
Uh-huh.
All right.
I would be surprised if we see it getting to that.
We get the streams back up.
Ah, yes.
I'll stream Levi.
I'll stream.
Give Merky a break. Actually, do something.
Thanks.
Sec, I gotta get the IP. Everyone always gets very hyped when they see the Tronics appearing.
It's a fun map to watch. Played competitively.
Very true. 1 sec, got like 50 screens to figure out.
Or a rush, mate.
I think from a casual perspective, watching someone be good at Messer and someone being average at Messer is completely different to someone being good at Tronic and average at Tronic.
True.
You can literally can see the difference with Tronic. I think that's why it's so entertaining to watch.
Okay, heads up whenever Emil is ready.
Yeah, he is put R.
Alright, Pac-Man ready. Alright, cool. First match. First map.
Yeah, there you go.
In finals.
First match of the grand finals. Here we go.
Get hot.
So, as we were saying, let me check again. 13 minutes ago, Levi just got rank 2 on this. But it's actually tied with Emil's current PB. So
they both have the same PB.
This is the first time in the tourney we're seeing 2 competitors literally have the same PB. And funnily enough, it's ranked 2 and 3. So only one person's done this faster.
Levi has just got units that I have never seen any of the other players so far in the tournament.
I just saw that as well.
Yeah. Plus 36 on WR.
So Levi wanted to world record Chateau, and he did. And this was the other map he wanted to world record, but since then Josh has taken 07 off it, so I don't think we will see a record on it.
Wait, so technically his time now would have been WR.
Yeah.
But Josh took more time off it.
Yeah, exactly. But this is one of the ones that he wanted to record in the 10 minutes.
Yeah.
But I would I'd be very surprised if we saw that now, because the time is quite a lot better than it was.
But we don't know, man. Like, Levi literally could have just gotten an 07. He could have just been shopping runs, pracking, like he did on Chateau, to do it in the 20. You don't know with Levi. And he's getting...
Really?
I was going to say consistently good units, but... Cast a curse.
I mean, it was. If he made that, that was good.
Emil's about to finish his first run.
Emil's on a really good run.
He had a good CP too there, but he lost
a lot of time lost on last CP.
That could have been a solid time with a good end.
Levi's units once again, I've just never seen them before at the start.
Yeah, 1500 previous window, kind of nuts.
He had like 1540 before.
It's crazy.
I don't know how
the deviance like he has.
Okay, this end is clean.
We've seen.
This could be WL.
Ah, he missed
a good end.
Oh, that was
no good end. Yeah, plus overall, rank 2 on the map.
If he did not mess up that last round, that was record 100%.
So he is just absolutely wiped Emil straight away.
On a map like this.
Yeah.
Wow.
Like, that last ramp was not even good, but he has still proven that he can always get WR.
He was just too high onto last, just a little bit too high.
Poor Emil, man. I mean, it wasn't his map choice, but at the same time, like, it's a map that he still has rank 3 on just now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. This run is like, nuts by Levi. Yeah, like, 1540 through that window, nearly.
Yeah, because you don't want to focus on the CPR there, going for the window,
the
right?
Units make so much difference, yeah.
Yeah.
Obviously, you can't be plus, like, 0.4, but you'll earn it back if you have those units.
Yeah. Okay, here we go again.
1520. Oh, he is.
You've casted.
Wasn't the quickest DP one.
Oh, sure.
Emil also getting the same units.
The decent run. It's going to improve his time.
He did not.
Under flicked.
I think he's going to have to do a perfect flick into that end hole. If he wants to match Levi.
It's true that I was pointed out that this is Emil's like map pool pick though, but I think he would not choose this against Levi though, given the choice. Like against maybe anyone else in the tourney, why not? But here is not a winning game.
Josh feels bad. But at least 2 WRs this stream.
Nah. 1500 viewers, kind of pog.
I'm sure we have broken the 1500, because every time I look, it's like 1480 or something.
Yeah.
Yeah. Pretty crazy. I'm sure we have it. I'm proud of this community.
Shout outs to everyone watching. Love you guys.
Emil falls off a ramp with decent units.
Surf's only popular because of Leafy, based opinion.
Yeah.
Hey guys, today I'm going to bully children online.
He made
Don't bully me for my voice cracks.
You're not a child, you're 22.
Yeah, you didn't bully, like, it wasn't only children, was it? Or was it actually just only children? I can't say I've recorded in Leafy's videos.
Yeah, okay, this really Levi run is insane.
This Levi run is really good.
Let's see.
If he gets a good cut into end, which it looks like he has, but
that
it's a bit of a
high.
Yeah,
but he's just have 2
units. Yeah, look at the units on WR. 1500. Oh,
wow.
Also,
holy shit.
Wow. That is an end if ever I've seen it.
He's not fucking about.
That is a crazy end.
I've never seen a 1500 end.
I've never seen an end like that. Remember, was it Merky or Caff? Which one of you were saying, like, I want to see Josh's end because you've never seen, like, someone go minus on the end?
Yeah. Thanks, Levi.
This is crazy.
And we're back.
Really good.
And he's already back again.
He's pretty good.
That is it. He's done it.
Oh my
WR.
God.
What the
fuck? Oh my God.
He's WR.
Yeah, sorry, Merky.
Yeah, I thought, I didn't think we would see that, but he's practiced.
An entire house right now, Merky.
Wow, okay, yeah. Hey, man, I didn't put any wager on it.
Okay, and
wait, now he's minus 13 on CP1 with more units.
His own CP1, which his own CP1 was plus 09.
So. He's just going again.
He's getting nervous now.
But I think it'll be like plus 06. Yeah. Oh, that'll make the end.
Thanks, Caff.
Go for it.
Yeah, you can.
I mean, if it's only fair, we gave the same thing to you, so.
Yeah, so Levi clearly was doing some practice in the break between his matches, and it has clearly paid off.
Someone was saying couldn't even cast or curse him.
It's not possible. Yeah, he doesn't get
attacked. That's how you know.
He's broken free from the chains.
He is literally spell immune. Like, actually. You can't do anything to him.
There's no debuff at all.
I like that spam.
Emil has just opted to go to Andromeda, as we were saying before.
What does the top look like on that?
I will check for you.
Has he lost a round this tournament, Levi?
No.
Did he lose a round last tournament?
Nope.
No.
So this is two tournament wipes in a row if he wins all of these games.
Yep.
Correct.
Disgusting. That is... looking
and
looking
two at, WRs this tourney.
Yeah.
Looking at Andromeda, Levi is rank 2 with 0.02 behind.
Oh, really?
And yeah, and Emil is 0.1.
That must have been recent. Can you check when that was?
Our top 10. Oh, wait, no, I can just go our info check him. No, it was July 1st, so that was 10 days
ago.
That
was at the beginning. I didn't see this.
Yeah. I did
see I always thought he didn't light the map.
I saw
Fishu
in chat going, I'm going to lose a WR soon. he is the current Andromeda WR holder, the next map in the pool, for anyone that doesn't know.
Yep.
So he is already shaking in his boots that Levi might potentially break the record on there.
Based opinion, but Ignis technically wins because he's the only one with a map in the pool that hasn't been beaten.
Is that actually a true fact?
I mean... apart from Andromeda, that's
I think Fish had Andromeda going in.
Yeah.
Tronic hasn't either.
Oh, true, Tronic.
Yeah.
Someone's saying Levi lost a round to Marble in the final, but I think that was the first.
That was the first one.
That was not the second one we're talking
He was on a laptop and the ping on, I think, Stick. I think Stick are the only two maps he dropped, if I'm correct, and it was Shula ping.
He lost two rounds in the first tourney to Chromalia and someone else. I forget now. Marvo.
Levi wants Andrew.
Okay. Yeah, we can just end this round.
Yeah.
First round goes to Levi.
Well, I mean, there's not much you can do if you're Emil when your opponent just 0-4's record on a 30-second map.
So we're going on to Emil's pick here. But as we were saying, Levi is still favored on here with his current PR. It's such a tough position for Emil here. Like, every map that is in the pool, Levi has a good PR on or has banned.
Copy me.
Is there actual? You go with like that, like you don't just stick to like a...
I mean, it's a curve, you can't just make up a chunk of 10.
I mean, true. Ready, by the way, if you want to check if Levi is.
Yep, we are just waiting on Levi. He said his wrist is sore, so he's probably just stretching and...
doing
in his room.
He searched up a YouTube tutorial on how to cure RSI with like daily practices.
How to
dude, my wrist has been getting sore lately.
Yeah.
Bump.
A good PR on literally record here. Yeah.
Caff, can you do the honors?
Way heavier, but mate, is what I meant to say. I don't know. My brain. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, out of it, dude.
You can call I've had too many nights of like 4 hour sleep.
Don't call me buddy, pal.
became Canadian for a second.
I don't mind the patronizing names, to be honest.
Issue is apparently shivering right now, according to Vay.
He's quaking in his boots. Okay. I don't think so, Levi is going to record this.
You've said that as he's got a perfect CP1, which is one of the hardest parts on that.
Yeah, going like minus on the last CP though is just like, look, I won't say it's not possible, but it's just like so tough.
I saw someone asking how the maps are picked for the tourney. Every single competitor gets to pick one map of their choice, and then when it comes to each round, when it's a best of three, seven maps get randomized and appear, and then for this format, which is a best of five, it's 11 maps get randomly appeared. And then it's a pick ban system.
Yeah. Quite a good system, honestly.
Thanks, I made it up myself.
You're welcome.
Thanks, dude. No, I kind of just like Emil, copied it from.
Levi was going back there.
Emil approaching the end.
Gonna be
he has sniped at 0.31. That is rank 13 on the map.
Does,
out of 4,000.
Does my stream look okay, Louie?
Yeah.
Because I'm streaming with the file upload. I think
it looks
lagging.
Yeah, no, your Discord stream share looks fine. It's just when you tab out, right. It's the only time I don't see anything occurs.
Cool.
Levi's not fucking around with these units.
He's got a few units in his back pocket, that's for sure.
This is a really good
3,800
to have early
yeah.
On.
You want to see 3,800 there.
Bit of a moon, but still a pretty good complete.
2,800.
Beats Emil.
Yeah, this map is brutal.
Faster.
Like that looked like such a fast run.
0.28 is also rank 9. Emil can beat that, but he has pressure on him now.
This he is knows, good units.
He knows
this is really good
okay.
Units.
Well, yeah. This is better than what he had in the last run.
Oh, okay.
And he's got a really low end, which is good. With a good board, this should be like a plus 13, I'd say. 16.
Wow. 60. That is close to Emil's PR on the map.
Yeah.
That is rank 7 just now. Because a lot of the times in the top 7 are
your
actually
your speed is how many degrees you turn per second. So your speed 360 would mean you hold your turn bind and you're turning 1 times per second. 1 revelations. Revolution?
It's revolution.
Revolution.
Yeah.
Thought you were like joking. Why did you actually
I was
say
thinking
that?
Of vodka.
The Bible. Oh, okay.
Vodka.
Was anyone building? They got no mats.
Revelation a map? Or no, that's Revolution. Wait.
Yeah, Revolution is a map.
Okay.
Yeah.
Based on turning, funnily enough.
Yeah, it's the one that's got
that makes so much more sense.
Yeah.
You know when you think of a word and you're just like you actually think about it and realize like the quite literal name of it.
Yeah.
God damn.
I haven't even made that connection until just now.
It's a spin map.
Yeah.
Revelation is a book in the Bible. That's probably why I'm such a child of God that I was just thinking about the Bible.
Oh, yeah.
It's an easy mistake to make.
Seeing Emil come up towards the end here.
They're both having really solid units.
Just bam, units bam, there. Deal. He's hitting the 3,800 mark. I don't know
this
if it's enough.
This Emil run could be better than
he
Levi's.
Is Proga at the end.
Oh.
The famous
I love
Proga.
How we're still calling it that, man.
No BM
Proga
to
can
Proga.
Literally be anything, but he can't make the end of Andromeda.
No hate to him, though. It's just the fact that we saw it happen so many times in that one match.
Proger just can't, I mean, respect not for be Grady. A meme, can he?
No.
He's just always going to be the subject of some joke.
Good units from Levi. Really good units from Levi.
29.
This end could be
does the end well. This could be like under point one.
This is so
fast. That is really fast.
And he's even GG at the end.
Oh, okay.
Plus 5. Oh, 5!
Yeah.
That is rank 3. That is what Cole, who used to have the WR at one point, had.
Watch out, fish.
That is so GG.
It just sucks being the other person.
Like, yeah.
What can you do against this? You just can't do anything.
You now have to beat your PR, which is something that you've put tons of time into.
You have
into.
To beat the WR to beat him.
Well, thankfully on this map, not yet. There's time will tell.
That run could have been.
Oh, he is minus on CP1.
Tux, you might know. The ramp after the right turn, kind of midway through CP1, is it better to board over the spine of that or from the back?
I think over the spine's better, but you just want better units around the corner because it's shorter.
Like, yeah, because you kind of see units. Like people, depending on the flick they get, will do either.
Yeah, it's a mix of both.
Because like, depending on what flick you get, the spine.
Yeah, over the spine gives you a really good drop for next ramp, and you get really good units from next. Levi on some spicy units again, but he just doesn't make the ramp.
And I can confirm Levi's not turn binding the ramp. He was thinking about it, but I think he's
solid units again.
He knows.
Very solid units again.
2900 going onto the ramp again.
Yeah.
Landed low.
This isn't going to be good 05 time. I don't
You'd
think.
Be surprised. Oh, he's
moving
again.
Yeah.
08 though.
Yeah. Actually, genuinely like, was surprised. I didn't think that would be only slower.
Because of how low he landed on third blast. If you land low and you get the units, it's like the perfect cut.
It's insane though, because that's rank 4. Like, just again and again, he's setting literal top times that people spend like hours on trying to get some of these, and he's just doing it within a 10-minute time limit.
Bold of you
Emil,
to assume
Emil's
some people
is getting fast runs. Yeah.
I know it's bold to assume that.
Only hours.
2-1. That's an improvement on his current, actually. Like, that's
he just
still
needs those
really
good ends, that's all. Because he's plus
really
07 on CP2.
That's a rank 7 time on the map. Like, it's nothing to scoff at.
Yeah, on a tier 1 like this, like, a rank 7 time is very good.
He's doing well for the pressure he's under and the opponent he's against.
Yeah.
Why have you been actually by Longbow of all people?
Why? Has someone compared Levi to fucking Khabib Nurmagomedov?
One of my friends compared him to a Faker from League. He doesn't know much about surf, he just asked, is Levi basically the Faker of League? And I had to say yes.
Is that the Jordan guy?
Yeah.
Emil approaching the end again.
Not an improve, I don't think.
2 circs now, but it's still showing his consistency. Oh, he is good rounded when there's still 30 seconds left.
Levi's going to finish one, but it's not an improve.
Yeah.
But that was... he was plus 0.19 on CP2 and a plus 0.19 end. So he's actually matched the last CP, which I said is incredibly hard to do. Both players getting their last runs in now.
One last run.
Emil Levi's just got over the start zone. He's going to finish a run, but this is probably not going to improve his current time. 2-2 now. 0.01 off. Again, that was like a rank 7 again.
Yeah, but
against
it's
anyone else in this tourney,
anyone else,
well.
You'd be home free with that time.
So that's a good round there. We're going on to what next? Mesa time.
Mesa, that's gonna be a good round.
This can go either way because the end is so difficult. Like, the end is so precise to get a fast CP that you can't just say that it's all on Levi or all on Emil. It's going to be pretty close, I think.
Shaved by the bell, says Melinda. Potentially.
Emil says he is ready.
Levi claims he's getting old at the ripe old age of 17.
Yeah, he's suffering from like wrist soreness and the poor man.
That's confusing though, because he doesn't grind as hard as others, right?
No.
Like when Maybe he plays, it's
probably just precision. It hurts your wrist.
Yeah.
Since he plays, and he like doesn't he snapboard onto ramps with his sense?
Yeah.
Interesting.
I think it's fast movements like that that do it. That's why B-hoppers get it a lot.
Keep that wrist safety out there, chat.
Started calf.
Respect your body.
Yeah.
Man is ready.
Got the timer counting down.
Gonna assume Pac-Man is ready. Yeah. I'd spec calf.
My bad.
Nah, you're good.
Thanks, man. Appreciate
few
it.
Words of encouragement.
I got you.
Here. someone was asking what snapboard is, if anyone wants to explain it.
Tux? Merky?
Not me.
I can explain it. Basically, the comfortable way to board ramps is over the spine. So you're already aligned with the surface that you're about to board. But a snapboard is like what you do when you're boarding a ramp from the same side. So you've kind of got to angle yourself in towards the face of the ramp and then right as you approach it, turn back out to match your direction to like the surface of the ramp, essentially. And often on maps like tier ones, it's like fastest to stay low on a ramp. So you have to do that kind of snapping motion quite quickly and precisely right at the bottom of a ramp. And that's something that Levi is really good at and a lot of good tier one surfers are really good at. But yeah, I'm sure that doing it for a long time on a lot of maps can just like hurt your wrist because it's just a little like snapping movement that you do.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I can see that inducing the RSI that Levi is currently experiencing.
I can see why you're taxing on your wrist as well. Like, it's quick movements is what ruins you.
An old Aussie surfer in chat currently called Mids. Apparently he's had 3 surgeries for jiggle like carpal tunnel, jiggle like surf. So it's no jokes.
Remember to stretch in between playing.
An example is like the skip ramp that Levi's just boarded. That's kind of like a snap board.
Yeah.
Like what you call a snap board.
Have both players landed the skip yet? I may have just anti caster. Yeah, I think I just anti-caster cursed because Emil literally just landed it as I said that.
Ever before seen curse.
You know, I don't think I've seen any players finish the map yet, so
yeah. Imagine the fucking curse would just get reversed. I don't think Levi's ever been lost around.
Levi hit the skip with really good units.
Yeah, I've noticed what Levi
actually,
does.
On
is he actually... He has enough units to like turn right in the skip, like not like everyone's just like going directly straight for it, trying
he is
to make
gunning
it.
Gunning the
sand. This is fast.
He's hit a really good flick. A really good flick.
No way.
If he finishes this end, this is solid.
It's not world record. He's gone really fast.
It's still
up,
it's yeah. .07.
Emil
that's rank
just
3.
See that and just be like, that, what
yeah.
am I even meant to do?
That, bruh. His response was, bruh. That's insane.
Yeah.
Well, you don't want to call it early, but
it's
really
be a
not
tough
much
one.
Emil can do.
Go back to when I said that. Yeah.
How do you compete with that?
I don't know.
There isn't a way. The only other person to get a better time than that is Cole, and he's someone who has almost 100, no, 200 more completions on the map than what Levi does.
Not trying to flame Cole, but he has 30,000 attempts on the map.
Yeah.
And he's the only other person to get a faster time than the one Levi just set.
That's not flaming Cole, he's put his due into this map. This was considered
yeah.
his map. But
at least he's got a good time to show for the 30,000 yeah. attempts.
Well, he's still leagues ahead of like rank 3 on
yeah.
those, but like when the fact that Levi's just set that time.
Yep.
Yeah, you can bind a key to toggle your yaw speed. So for maps where there's some fast spins and then some slow turns, you can bind a key that toggles the yaw speed that you use. Or you can just change it completely by just typing in console.
I think Levi has like maybe over 3k hours, maybe under, I'm not 100% sure. But he doesn't stream much because of Australian internet, but if you guys want to see more shit like this, there's his Twitch, go give him a follow.
He's we'll be shouting out
the rarest time he's... Yeah.
Another
yeah.
very good run.
When he does
very good
has
clutch.
He made that?
Nope.
Very good clutch. And that's the flick that's rough.
Oh, he wanted to see how fast this run was, so he's going into
yeah.
the save block.
Also, a note, when Levi does stream, you're pretty much guaranteed
that
to see
angle
it
is just
yeah.
ridiculous. Like, what is that angle?
This
that
map
sense,
is capped.
Barely.
Yeah.
That would have been, that would have been WR.
Minus 04. Okay.
Oh my god.
What?
That literally would have been it.
He could have
yeah, this
beat
map
WR
is
that attempt.
3.5k max fall.
Now all he has
and
to do is land that run.
Anywhere.
That prac run he just yeah. hit. It was his run until last ramp. All he had to do was hit that last ramp.
Hit the ramp.
Yeah.
He didn't take WR, but he just learned that a run that he
yeah.
failed could have been WR.
That, yeah, that wasn't WR. That was he failed last, went back, and redid last.
He must have set a save lock
yeah.
while he was mid-run.
Yeah.
Because you do have time, like, after this corner here, when you're going straight, you have
yeah.
a little bit of time to just quickly hit save lock.
But it shows how possible it is for him.
Yeah.
During a tourney, when he's played the map for only 6 minutes just now, like...
On probably the most...
Huh?
I'd say this is the most iconic surf map. Maybe Utopia.
So...
This or
yeah.
Utopia.
Looking at Cole's CPR, he's ranked 2. He goes plus 07, plus 0.1, plus 09, and then minuses the end by 06. So as you see, Levi beating the end, there's obviously still a lot of time in the end if you just get that one insanely lucky flick.
Also, Emil finishes
not lucky
his
precise.
First run. He gets 0.58, which is rank 10. Like, that is still a top 10 on this map, like one of the most iconic maps, is actually really
yeah.
good. That's rank 10 out of 11,000. No, yeah, 11,000 people.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, you've got it right.
Yeah, my brain had to stop for a
second. Double check the map.
Yeah.
I have actually. It might have been a bit of time lag or something like that, but I have seen Levi practice a minus 0.24 run on this map to Cole's run, which would be minus 0.21 to the current record.
Yeah.
So there is still time
it's an impossible
left in
map
this
to
map.
Hit those runs on.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Beetle. Someone pasted a Beetle copy pasta and he banned them. And I sort of
now
think
just...
it.
Yeah,
I think it was. I'm not 100% sure, but I think it may have been Gavin.
Oh, Gavin.
I could be wrong on that, so like, don't quote me on that.
Levi has once again got the units post-skip.
They're a little bit slow.
Yeah, he lost a few. Well, he's lost a few more now, but...
Yeah, this is not WR potential.
But it's just end practice for him, which is what you need. Yeah.
He is going for the... Like, I think he knows he's won, and now how he's going for, like, the real end cut, which is just... You wouldn't go for it in a tournament usually unless you thought you were safe. Emil hits the skip as well. He's pretty consistent at it, I will admit.
Emil's
that.
Really good at the skip, yeah.
Yeah. These players will make it look easy. That skip, it took like so many years of this map being out for someone to do that for the first time.
Because it was known from like CSGO servers and such, but that was mostly for higher tick.
Yeah.
So it wasn't expected.
You were on a good run.
Oh, well, you have done the funny.
Yeah, very good end. Never I'm mind,
watching though. Watching the stream and not the stream.
Yeah, I'm casting with chat.
Instead of surfing, he has stood on the spine. You hate to see it.
And Levi was also the first person to do the skip on 64 tick CSGO on Surf Heaven.
True.
Did he do that after getting the source like skip done?
Yeah.
Okay. Or he just learned it on CSGO, you think?
Yeah, I was about to say, because if you did it there first, like, imagine how easy it would feel coming
out. Yeah, he'd be smirking when he came back to CSS.
Yeah. Those two ticks.
Yeah, I asked him and he said he finished after hitting that skip for the first time on Surf Heaven. That was the run he finished.
Oh, okay. So
I can tell you now, I was there. It did not take him a long time.
Yeah.
He like instantly started hitting the skip.
I think that is that tie. Yeah, that ties his current. Equal.
Yeah, it equals his time. Emil's safing the end a bit. You want 33:25 off last ramp is like the good speed.
Yeah.
Either way, he's just set. He's just set rank 10 time twice, which is really good. Just in this setting, it is not enough.
GG. And
that's it.
That is it. Emil did start a run. We can see if he can improve his time.
It's the skip.
He does.
It's about 30 units down on optimal, but
this is his little lap. He's out here.
This is encore.
Exactly. Honestly, big shout outs to Emil here. GG, dude.
Unfortunate.
Said it multiple times against anyone else.
He would have been doing well.
Emil would be like fucking destroying. But you just can't compete with Levi.
And that is well played, Levi. That is the third tournament in a row that he's taken home. So congrats to Emil, but congrats to Levi as well.
Yeah, congrats to the absolute goat. Oh, the animations here.
Oh, there it is.
I like that.
No, production quality.
Oh! Boom. There it is.
That is sick.
Pog.
That is awesome.
Woo! Nice.
Goal. I'm finally glad we paid you, Nykan.
Very well done to everyone who played. I think everyone put on a good show. I enjoyed watching it at least.
That was crazy. I mean, the amount of WRs we just saw there towards the end. And also thanks to the viewers for watching. Couldn't have done this without you.
Who's clapping?
Me.
Fair enough.
Oh, we've got a congratulations from all the Russian surf community. Thank you, Russia.
I mean, are we able to do a Levi?
Take my number one.
Or is he going to pass on that?
I think he's got to go fix his hand.
True.
Let's see if we can get Levi in here.
if you'd like to see his yearly word count.
Yeah.
What do I say?
Just you chat shit for a while. No pressure though if he does not want to talk.
Yeah. Yeah, don't, yeah. It's not peer pressure, Levi. If he wants to, cool. If he doesn't, also absolutely fine.
If Emil come. Okay, oh. Levi's in if Emil is in.
Oh, this is gonna be cute.
Oh, they're
all
coming.
Right. All right. Yes. We're gonna get the grand finalists into the cool.
Someone has to believe I's a girl.
I mean, he doesn't talk much, so might be.
I need to pick my mic up from behind Mogaga.
Which mic? Emil probably has 10. We already know that he's like the king of peripherals.
Hold it.
There's a snowball. Let's have a snowball.
Ooh.
I have one.
Pause champs incoming.
Yeah.
Oh, can we, okay, they can hear you now. Oh, they. Oh, oh okay.
No? Alright.
Alright, should we bring Emil in first?
Yep.
Yeah.
Let's bring him in while we're waiting for Levi.
Uh-huh. Welcome.
Thank you. Hello.
Congratulations.
Hello.
Good job, Emil.
Thank you, thank you. It was really fun. Thank you for the invitation.
Thank you.
No problem.
Thank you for playing.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling over the top.
Oh, yeah.
For sure. Is that the champ?
Hello, Levi.
It is.
He's
the champ.
Congrats, yeah. Levi. You're fucking insane.
Thanks, bro. Thanks, bro.
Welcome, welcome.
So, Emil, I want to know a bit about what your practice regime was like, because I think you were more on the side of people who practice quite a bit more. So maybe if you could just fill in the viewers on like what preparing for a tournament looks like.
I think I just picked out the maps that I could have a chance of beating Kush on. So I just practiced basically all the maps except the few ones the first week, but then I had to go on vacation the next one. And so I just came home the day before tourney.
Yeah, sweet. So you would say you prepared mostly for your first match against Kush then?
Oh, definitely. I didn't plan on coming any further than maybe beating Kush.
So you were just suffering from success afterwards. You were just not sure completely what to do.
I was just mind blown because I didn't have timer, like the what's it called? The results of the times on my screen, so I had to like ask people on Discord if I won or not.
Did that help with nerves? Because personally, that would make it harder for me if I didn't know whether I was winning or losing.
I have no clue. I think I left it on accidentally. But yeah.
Fair enough. And did you find yourself getting nervous at times, or were you mostly calm?
Me again?
Yeah.
I don't
definitely get nervous.
Yeah, I. Yeah, I mean, of course, Levi is a machine. He doesn't get nerves. But I think what helps the most is being the underdog. So when I got my seeding, I was like much happier because I wouldn't have the high expectations.
Hmm. Yeah,
that's something I kind of want to ask Levi. Did you get nervous at any point? Because I think I only saw shakes in Quickie, but I couldn't tell if that was just.
It was a little bit like heart rate.
Yeah,
it was mainly just the shakes. Like, I can handle my heart rate.
Yeah,
I can't handle the shakes. I might make it.
Wow.
Yeah, because that's what I thought. Because all the earlier rounds, I didn't see a single like budge from you. But on Quickie, I saw a little bit of nerve when you saw how fast you could potentially go.
The first round against Greenwood on Chateau, I was really shaky.
Are you glad that you managed to redeem yourself though for that?
Yeah. Hell yeah. Thank you, username.
That's the username. Good man.
I like how shaky, though, still ended with a plus 04 in, like, the first minute.
Yeah, respect.
Well played by both of you.
Yeah, definitely. You both did so well.
That's quite fun.
I'm gonna go to bed now because I've school tomorrow. In 4 hours.
Currently 4 a.m. for Levi, for those who are wondering. So he has school today.
It's rather a nut.
Actually, yeah. Before you head off, how is your wrist feeling? Because you kept saying throughout like different matches there that you're having to like take breaks.
It feels fine now.
Is that like common for you to get wrist pain while playing?
I've been going for like 6 hours straight.
Practicing. Okay. Oh, so you were playing like in between other matches as well then?
Yeah.
Okay. Whereas that's not like what the amount you'd regularly play?
Yeah, I would never play over like 2 hours.
Okay.
Yeah, fair play. Well, we'll let you go. Well played.
GG.
Thanks to the people watching. Thank you.
True.
Yeah.
So many people turned up.
If you guys have any shout outs, Levi and Emil, you can do that now as well.
Levi?
Shout out Dildog98.
Good man.
Shout out Mom.
Oh,
the map?
Oh. No, just my actual mom. She racing. Alright, I'm heading off.
Okay.
Alright, guys. Thanks for the interviews.
Taking part. Congrats.
Okay. Are we gonna look
at the predictions that I think for the most part got absolutely ruined today. I don't know what Merky picked. I know what I picked.
Someone was saying that in the predictions page for the challenge, not a single person got all of them right.
Nobody got them all right.
Wow.
Yep.
That's a lot of excess.
So,
okay, there's
contrasting Levi.
Didn't we all have the same picks, me, you, and Louis?
I think so,
yeah.
So we got 10 points, right? 2, 3, 4,
maybe, 5, I think it was Marble not making it to the grand final that threw me off. Let's see what mine shows. Oh, no, never mind.
Yeah, because you got the bronze match correct.
Oh, is that...
Caff didn't get the bronze match correct.
Right.
Oh, yeah, mine's different to that. Damn.
So that's 9 out of 16, is it?
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. Oh, no, that's 10.
Oh, 10. It's 10.
Yeah, it's 10. I can't see mine yet.
So we all managed to get, like, quite a fair amount, right? It was just the 1, 2, 3, 4, upsets from certain.
There were a few upsets, yeah.
The 3 people from the challenge link. I know 2 of them, but if you're called Levi for the W, we don't know who you are.
No, there's someone below all of that called Easy Win that got 14 out of 15.
But he only got 23 points, why?
Because the points work, first round is 1 point, second round is 2 point,
etc. He technically lost.
Later in the round that you get.
Technically.
The 3 winners, Horty is a Russian guy, Horty Sad, I think I recognize that name, if he's in chat.
Yeah.
We don't know who Levi for the W is. An Epic Man 67, I'm presuming, is someone's name.
I might be able to like
that name in KSF Surf Channel earlier talking. I'm pretty sure I read something like that.
Yeah, I might be able to check, if people have an email linked to their account, if they even have an account. But if they don't, then I just I can't do anything.
There is definitely a Russian guy called Horty Sad, though, so I'm presuming that's the first
one. I know who that is. That's his Twitch username, so...
Yeah.
I'll get in contact with you, and I'll also get in contact with the people who won VIP yesterday, and we can sort that out for you guys.
You have a lot of contacting to do.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I know half the people,
It's been a fun 2 days. Shout out to Nykan, who... Without none of this would be possible. Shout out to Merky for helping me a lot with like organizing it. Shout out to Louie and Tux for casting, for guest casters, for competitors, and just chat for just vibing, just being here. Like, this is insane.
Biggest shout out to Nykan.
100 viewers.
Nykan kind of 1v9'd.
Yes.
Oh, and shout out Melinda for being bold.
The real winner was the friends we made along the way.
There are no winners.
So, we raid in Amaranth?
Why have you said this?
I think Dream is live. Maybe we raid Dream.
I think on that note, we'll send it out to the outro, but we appreciate you guys watching, and hopefully we see you to the next one.
See you another time.
Thanks for watching.